Hey, what's happening, guys? My name is Peter Olinto, and I'm one of the lead instructors here at the Wiley Review for the CFA. And we just want to talk to you a little bit about those ugly pass rates. How low can you go? Well, the first thing I'm going to tell you is the CFA Institute has released a video explaining what they believe is behind the low pass rates. The long and short of it is, no, they are not making the exam more difficult. They're keeping the rigor relatively constant. And so, you know, really the problem has been we are attributing it to the pandemic. The delaying of exams, the starting and stopping of reviews really interrupted people's study plans and even the ability to focus, right? I mean, this has really got to be, at front and center in your life for that period of time while you're studying with everything going on with family, friend, job. We understand. But we're getting back to normal. All righty. So what can you do to be properly prepared? Number one, be properly motivated. Why did you sign up for this exam? What is in it for you? And let's say you've done your due diligence. You've got to maintain that throughout your studies to push you through the times where you're like, do I really want to put myself through this? You know, there's too many opportunities to cop out. If you're serious about this, you're going to do it and you're going to do it the right way. Step number two is, okay, the 300 hours you got to put into study. You know, it's not something, I'll tell you, I firmly believe in that. I'm a professional test taker between the bar exam, the CPA, the different levels of the CFA. You know, you've got to put in a lot of time to prepare for the exam, but it's not just putting in 300 hours and I'll check a box, you're going to pass. No, it's how did you put in the 300 hours? You can't cram for this in a month or two. I don't even think in 3 months if you're working full time and you got a family and other stuff. You know, 100 hours, a month. You know, when you're working full time, you know, it's 25 hours a week, 15 hours on the weekends, 2 hours a day, 7 days a week for 3 months with no breaks. I mean, it seems like a pretty tall order. Law of diminishing marginal returns, all I'll say about that. I think it's a 3 to 6 month sweet spot. You know, you really got to be looking to say, hey, what's a reasonable amount of time to study during the week and on weekends? And then do I have time and you need to make time to do cumulative reviews along the way? And then when you're done studying all the new content, have you left yourself time to do a thorough final review 2, 3, 4 weeks before the actual exam date? Because you know what, man, that time period just before the exam is critical because you got to summarize, prioritize, holistically view this curriculum and understand why you're studying these different topics. And it's not just memorization, as you all know. If you've been practicing, you could see even math intensive topics to testing and theory. It takes time and effort, being properly motivated, studying in exam conditions, computer-based exam. You're going to have distractions, right? You don't have pen and paper. You got to use the whiteboard. How do you practice questions? You know, when you take your mock exams, are you using a whiteboard? Don't use pen and paper. You know, put those earplugs in so you're not as distracted by people coming and going in these test centers while you're taking the exam. So look, you can and you will do it if you're properly motivated and you put in the time and effort. It all starts with a good study plan, though, okay? Try to put that study plan together. Stick to it. Make sure it's realistic and you build in time for occasionally a day off and cumulative reviews, all righty? Good luck studying, guys, and hopefully we will see you in class at some point in time. Thank you for your time. Good luck.